time and hit it.
I think he wanted for a low blow action, Jim.
Low blow?
Yeah.
So the first warning of the fight goes to Hopkins.
We all knew that would happen, don't we? Hopkins played a smart game now. He's just trying to wait the kid out, let him get a little tired, then he'll start to do more work. Good left and right movement to keep him from planting on his punches so much.
Body shot by Taylor. Hopkins dodged the right hand very effectively. Two jab land for Taylor. And another. Crowd is getting very excited at the young fighter's prospects here. The sheer physicality of Jermaine Taylor is keeping Bernard Hopkins on the defensive. This is not great craft Taylor's showing you. It's energy. It's commitment. And Hopkins hasn't solved the puzzle quite yet.
Good right hand lead by Hopkins right there.
That may be a weapon that he'll begin to use more often.
And that's what he's trying to wait your man out, let him get a little tired, get used to his pace, get used to seeing the hand speed, then he'll start sticking his little shots in.
Well, one thing's for sure, from that distance, Bernard isn't going to win any rounds. Because from that distance, Taylor can land. He has the longer jab.
Watch your hands.
Good hook.
Good left hook by Bernard Hopkins. That one caught Taylor flush.
And he's trying to make Taylor get anxious and want to land punches, and he counted when he do it. That's what he wants to do.
Taylor attacks and lands a left and a right. Solidly, Hopkins smiled, but again, the energy level belongs to Jermaine Taylor.
Outside right. I'm smarter than you are. I want the outside right. Outside right. That's all it is. Outside right. You got double shots. Go with your doubles, baby. You're all right. Go with your doubles, okay? Nothing big. Nothing big. Just hit the target. Hit the target.
Okay. Body. So when you short that jab, the second one needs to be short because his ass is going down. It gives you some punching room. Once he drops, we need to work from underneath. You're missing some opportunities for body shot. Okay, I like the way you're coming down on that head.
Here you see Jermaine miss with the right, and there you see the low blow right there. The second was low too, and that's what the ref saw. Then he hit him with a good right hook to the head
while holding the back.
But the referee warned him for the low blows first.
You were right.
There's so much stuff he did at one time that Jay Nate didn't know what to say.
Average per round from CompuBox through the first three, Hopkins 4 out of 15 per round. Taylor 6 out of 36 per round. Harold, how do you have it so far?
Okay, Jim. 3 rounds to nothing, 30 to 27, Jermaine Taylor. Jim, number one, Jermaine Taylor's getting off first. Number two, landing the better shots. Number three, it's driving me crazy when Bernard Hopkins drops that left hand down to his email address, which he's got across his trunk, and he leaves himself wide open for Taylor's right hand. So based on aggressiveness, clean punching, 3-0, Taylor.
I think Nady might have warned Hopkins again for low blows there. He did get in another little shot.
See if Taylor does what Pat Brown told him to do.
Good left hook by Taylor. Backs Hopkins out of the exchange. And you saw Hopkins do something there that he does frequently and well. He managed to bump Taylor's hip going in, knocking off balance. Taylor landed the left hook anyway.
Stop.
Jermaine lands again, and Bernard grabs him.
Okay, now box.
No, much more of the attack now than we used to see at this point in the fight.
But he hasn't unveiled those doubles that Bowie Fischer was talking about. No double jabs, no double hooks. He definitely seems to understand that he's going to have to start scoring in the fight. Uppercut by Taylor.
Stop. Let go now. Let go.
He missed it just a little, but if Hopkins is going to lean in like that, he'll have to look out for that punch. And again, Taylor backs Hopkins out of the exchange.
Yeah, but he tried too hard with my hand. Hopkins saw it coming, beat him to the punch with the left hook then. Beautiful counterpunch by Bernard Hopkins.
Wonder if Jermaine should just ease off on the right hand.
He has to calm down, though.
He's doing fine with his left.
Can't win a fight being that anxious. Too anxious to you.
Stop! Right hand up. Hold on. Keep your head up.
This round is on the table in these last 30 seconds. And you saw Jermaine Taylor steal the first round with a late flurry. And he do the same thing here.
Still a little anxious. Bernard Hopkins has settled down, has found his rhythm a little bit, and he's waiting on Taylor to make mistakes, and that's all he's doing. He's waiting for him to make mistakes, and he'll counter. And that's how he plans on people.
Well, there are only 12 rounds in the fight. If you're down four, and soon to be down six or seven, you got to start thinking knockout. He's got to start winning rounds.
I think he won that round.
I think he won that round. Okay. They both tried to flurry late and steal it.
We got to stay on the outside. Outside rights, we got doubles coming back. Not big. Just hit the target. That's all we got to do. Hit the target. Hit the target and we go home.
I saw it.
Okay? He's giving you a lot of respect. Okay? Take that respect away. Start doubling those jabs. When he drops down, bang to the body, you're proud in yourself. Okay? Mm-hmm. He's just dropping down and you're overshooting. You need to get some body shots. The hooks and the combinations will open up. He's just walking around and you're chasing him. Put his ass in the closet. Here, immediately go to the
It was 114 degrees in the shade here 2 days ago at midday. A lot of people thought that Bernard Hopkins was going to put Jermaine Taylor into that kind of a cauldron with his experience and his great ring skills. It hasn't happened yet. Maybe still it will. But so far, Taylor is holding his own and at least on Harold Letterman's card, won the first three rounds.
I can almost guarantee you that it wasn't in Bernard's plan to win the first three rounds.
Big left hook by Hopkins. Taylor takes it well. Taylor was banging to the body. Hopkins got an excellent left hook upstairs. It's usually along about the fifth of the sixth round that Bernard begins to unveil his withering right-hand counterpunch.
Exactly.
Which I think is his most damaging blow.
Hopkins knows that this is a distance race.
Stop.
And doesn't mind if his opponent thinks it's a sprint in the early going. But you know, Tarver was a...
There's blood.
There's
a cut.
There's
a cut on the eye of Jermaine Taylor from a headbutt. This was something that could have been expected. Looks like the cut is well up on his forehead.
Ready? Come in. Box.
Definitely from an accidental headbutt. Taylor has never been cut. Now he's got blood streaming down the left side of his face. How big a distraction, Roy?
I don't think that'd be a big distraction, but you never can tell because he's already so excited.
And the blood is coming into his eye. You saw him fall with the left hand, and you see him attack with the right.
Stop!
Showing no respect for his elder.
Good hook by Bernard.
Step back, please.
I was talking about this as a metaphor for running, but because Taylor was a quarter miler and a star quarter miler in high school.
Hard right hand inside by Bernard Hopkins. Brilliant counter right hand. Caught Taylor flush. Hopkins' confidence now seems to be growing. The cut on Taylor's head may be bothering Jermaine. Hopkins starts to clown.
Don't hold him!
And gets in a little left hook as he breaks away.
Stop!
There's the right hand. That time he led with it.